takes the right amount of salt and the right amount of flour and the right amount of sugar and the right amount of grease or Crisco. I mean, do you ever just go lick a bowl of Crisco? But it's amazing how two cute girls can take sugar and flour and grease and heat and put it in there. I like my examples better. Well, who needs a plate? In this bite is grease, salt, sugar. Some of y'all are ready to go to Denny's right now. There's been heat applied for a long time. Hey, mom's not here. The point is, this is pretty good. That's our life. Isn't it interesting when it's all over? What does he say to his good and faithful servant? Well done. Take it out of the oven. They've been under the pressure, they've been in the heat, they've been in the fire. All of the things that you're going through in life, in the hand of a master chef, produces a beautiful product. Notice it didn't say all things are good. All things work together for the good. So whatever you're going through today, maybe you're real salty right now. Maybe about to choke it like it's flour, and you're dealing with greasy people that, you know, you can't ever get a handle on what they're doing. And, you know, it's like, y'all know what I'm talking about? Just dealing with people can be just like, you can't ever grasp what they're trying. You just stay in the process. All of that will work together if you love God and you're the call. And one day he'll say, that good and faithful servant. But the key is, you can't stop halfway through. You can't stop with individual ingredients. Say, this isn't working. You got to keep the recipe going. You got to keep it together. You got to make sure it's measured out according to what the chef says. You embrace that. You put it in. You stir it. You mix it. You fold it. What's all those terms? Whatever it says. When God is done. So here's the way we're going to end this. I want us all to stand together around the front.